What's up, everybody? My name is Kyle. This is my first video showing the 650 behind me. We're going to shout out to the local ATX ride or die group. There's about 25 of us in the neighborhood here that have these modified bikes. Shout out to those guys. These bikes wouldn't be possible if it wasn't for them. Anyway, this is my first video shooting for YouTube. So if it sucks, feel free to give it a dislike. Tell me how much I suck in the comments. Go easy on me. I try and do this in one take, no edits, just because I don't know how to do takes and I don't know how to do edits. So it is what it is. So let's get after it.
All right, here it is. This bike is got the name of Street Queen, just because she's street only. No dirt for this one. So kind of got a lot of interest in the bike when I posted some pictures of it, just asking about questions in regards to the battery, the forks, primarily. So I just wanted to touch base on a few things. If you guys find any of this interesting, give it a like, give it a share, do whatever the social media people do. And I'll try to keep these things coming. I'm gonna do this again. I'm gonna build another bike, this little guy right here. Probably similar setup, so let's get into this, starting from the front. So this fork, you can get these forks off Amazon. They're called fly pig forks. A couple questions were, do they bolt right up? And they do not. You have to get a couple of spacers that go in here inside the neck to make these forks work. And then you got to have a bolt up here that connects it all down here. If you guys are interested in these forks, they're great. I know a guy here locally that can make these, so just give me a holler. I can give you his contact information and you can get these forks bolted up too. Other question was if this brake is gonna be compatible, and these are the same bolt patterns as the Zoom brakes, but they are not compatible with this brake bracket. You have to make a bracket to make it work. Or you can have someone CNC something. I just put together something really quick just so I could ride it. I'll probably at some point get something made that's more heavy duty, but for now it works fine. And this wheel is gonna eventually be a 500 wheel, and I'm gonna put a matching 10-inch tire on the front. Gonna get that supermoto look right here, front and back. And the plastics, decals I did myself, the lights, I did it all myself, but this is yellow tint. You can buy yellow tint on Amazon to tint your lights. That's what I did. This right here, if you look, this is the throttle module for the domino throttle. It goes to the throttle, and then it goes into the Kelly controller from there. Coming up top, this is what the brakes look like from the top. Pretty good. I like them. The grips and all this stuff you can get on Amazon. The mirrors, I always have a mirror for street riding. I like to see what's coming up behind me. The switch right here, it's my primary switch. My voltage reading over here, if you can see that. This is the throttle, it kicks ass. Got a water holder right here, just water only, right? And then on the side here, it's got a switch panel. So I got one switch. It runs the headlights and the taillight right here. And then it's got another switch right here. And that one runs the LEDs. So there's LEDs underneath here on the sides. And then this little switch here, you flip it, turns on the fan motor. Not sure if that does anything, but it looks cool at night. So I'll take it. So that's that switch panel. The battery is a 36 amp hour, 72 volt battery, 150 amps burst. I don't even know what the mileage is on it because my butt can't take this ride for that long to figure it out. Let's see what else. The bars, all that stuff, you can find all this on Amazon. Kelly controller, KVD7212. With a down converter underneath the tank right here, it converts the power from 72 volts to 12 volts. Then it could power all my lights and stuff like that. The rear shock, mountain bike shock, from D&M. It's the second time I've used those shocks. Had good luck with them the whole time. And this is the battery specs if you guys want to check those out. This is a Kunray motor. Hey.
Mom.
No. Do you want to run?
No.
Okay.
I think he went to go pick up Marina and Bobby.
Okay. Well, then she'll be back soon. This is a Kunray motor, and I drilled the extra holes out just to get some more air through there. The heat sink from Electro and Company. The tire is the Kendra tire. You can get these from eBay. The sprocket. A few people had some questions about my gearing. So this is the original front sprocket. I gotta take a link out of my chain here, getting a little tight. No big deal. And this one here is a 50 tooth. With this setup, it gets 50 miles an hour. And I mean, it gets to 50 pretty quick too. And I don't want a big ass 80 tooth back here for the street. Kind of like the top speed. And I'm still running stock Kelly settings. What else? The light in the back, stuck that on. And this rear brake rotor. This is a 200 millimeter brake rotor. I had to make a bracket for that. I'll probably think of something more professional at some point on the brake, but for now it stops just fine. Yeah, that's about it, y'all. If you have any questions.
I need to get this out of here.
Okay, we'll get it. If you have any questions, hit me up in the comments. I'll respond to everybody.